Arriba la raza indeed. Eddie Guerrero and the LWO, along with the Mamacitas, partying Latino World Order style.
Well, it seemed to be a pretty festive atmosphere at the Fiesta Guerrero style, but that certainly wasn't the case for the Latino World Order last Thursday in Richmond, Virginia. We saw members of the NWO lead the LWO group almost flat. There were bodies all over Richmond, Virginia. You see Juventud Guerrero? He took a quick exit out of the back of the arena. I still don't have an update. When he was talking with Gene Okerlund, he led us to believe that there could have been a problem with Eddie Guerrero, that the NWO may have done something to Eddie.
I have not seen Eddie Guerrero tonight, and usually you can't go 4 feet without at least hearing that guy on Saturday night. But I haven't seen nor heard Eddie Guerrero here at the arena tonight. I don't know what happened Thursday night in Richmond, but it doesn't sound good, especially if you see the look of fear on the face of Juventud as he exited the building there in Richmond. He was not interested at all hanging around Thunder any longer than he absolutely had to.
That is a very strange situation, because we do have other LWO members in attendance here at WCW Saturday night.
Oh, yeah.
But there's no Eddie Guerrero. We all just wonder what role, if any, the NWO played in his absence.
Haven't seen Juventud here either. And we saw La Parca laid out backstage. I don't know what's up with that. Maybe the new boss, Ric Flair, can lay down the law to the new NWO Wolfpack, bring them in line. I know he wants to.
And I know that at the conclusion of this matchup involving Glacier, me and Gene Okerlund will have an exclusive interview with the Nature Boy Ric Flair, the new president of WCW, as well as, how does this sound, his new tag team partner, his son David. That coming up at the conclusion of this match. And fans in Minneapolis, Minnesota, which, by the way, is Ric Flair's hometown, his original birthplace, this upcoming Thursday, January the 14th. Tickets go on sale for Nitro. The live event at the Target Center will be Monday, February the 1st. But you have an opportunity to meet the Nature Boy as well as Mean Gene Okerlund. That's right. Ric Flair and Mean Gene will be at the Target Center box office Thursday, January the 14th from 10 to 11:30 a.m.
And don't forget, Mean Gene will be standing by, or is standing by, with Ric and David Flair backstage after this contest. Glacier and Lash LaRue. Whoa! Glacier, a couple of stiff kicks to the quads and the hamstrings of Lash LaRue. Sets LaRue up, shoots him in, misses the back elbow. LaRue, oh, nice hit. No, escape. Shoulder high, fireman's carry from Lash LaRue.
Wow!
Fireman's carry slammed by LaRue. Hooks the leg, back press, got the two count. Whoa!
Well, I think this youngster has shocked Glacier, and I think, just did you see the body language from Glacier as he reels back into the corner? He put the stop sign up for Lash LaRue. This young man has surprised Glacier in the early going.
Well, you know Lash LaRue has been watching videotape, will not leave himself susceptible to the ice picks. Ooh, drop toe hold, and LaRue throat first into the middle steel cable.
Well, brilliant execution that time by Glacier of the drop toe hold. I'm not sure if he knew how close he was to the ropes, but it was great the way he applied that drop toe hold, and then Lash LaRue went straight into the steel cable.
Wrist lock and just a mean right hand to the side of the head of Lash LaRue from Glacier.
Well, think about this man's change in attitude since his arrival on the scene in WCW some 2 years ago.
Well,
this is an all-new Glacier.
Well, nothing beats the change in attitude displayed by Kevin Nash last Monday night at the Georgia Dome. And Monday night from Knoxville on Nitro, Kevin Nash will once again try to prove if he is indeed the Giant Killer. It's the Giant and Big Sexy on Nitro Monday night.
I got one more for you. How about a change in attitude on the part of the total package? Lex Luger shocking us all by putting Goldberg in the torture rack, and that then allowed the other NWO members to totally embarrass
to totally humiliate Goldberg in his own hometown in front of over 40,000 fans. They handcuffed him to the bottom rope. Scott Hall with that taser gun, with that stun stick, as well as the spray painting by Hollywood Hogan and Kevin Nash and everyone else that was involved in that mess.
Glacier, oh, high backdrop on Lash LeRoux, the power and the height advantage of Glacier really playing into that one. LeRoux hit hard, but I am so disappointed. And, oh, hang on, inside cradle ball package from LeRoux, got the two count again. I'm disappointed in Lex Luger. Since Lex Luger made his return to WCW on the very first Monday Nitro, shocking the wrestling world, we have seen a reinvigorated Lex Luger. Has had more success than ever since his return, but now aligning himself with the likes of Hollywood Hogan and Scott Steiner and Buff Bagwell and Kevin Nash.
That has to be the biggest surprise. We're talking about a former world's heavyweight champion in Lex Luger. We're talking about a man who, prior to his association with the NWO Wolfpack, was really one of the top headliners for WCW and a great representative of that organization. When you think of World Championship Wrestling, the total package, Lex Luger was one of the first names that came to mind. And of course, the fans just loved him as part of the NWO Wolfpack, but this is a totally different Luger than we've ever seen before.
What he needs is another steel cage match with Bruiser Brody. That would help. Shoots Glacier in, LeRoux charges in, misses the clothesline. Oh! Cryonic kick. Caught LeRoux right on the chin. Knocked him into next month. And Glacier has him set up for the ice pick. Here we go.
He set him up first with the cryonic kick, like you mentioned, Scott. And there's that ice pick, that Asian spike, the hold that he brought back from the Orient with him.
Look at the face of Glacier. Look at the intensity and the anger written on his face. That's it. Referee Billy Silverman counting out. Young Lash LeRoux. Oh, was he done it? Glacier, what a vicious man.
Now, this youngster Lash LeRoux, who looked so impressive in the early going, wasn't even able to tap out. That's not, I guess it's a submission win. That's the way it'll go down in the record book. But realistically, he was not even able to submit. He wasn't able to tap out. The referee with the three count and Glacier with the win.
CNC could not continue. Glacier, a staggeringly vicious victory over Lash LeRoux here on WCW Saturday night. Fans, as we said, standing by backstage with Ric Flair and his son David Flair, let's send it back to our colleague, the one and only